Hi, Josh Skjold here for Folia Sound Studio. We hope you like this tutorial and find it inspiring, informative, and fun.
Hello again, guys of the web. Good to have you back in the studio. What you've heard in the very beginning was a fragment of a voiceover track recorded for us by our friend Josh Skjold, because this is what we're gonna talk about today. Creating a good sounding, ready for commercial use voiceover track. But not only that, because some of you may remember that recently I said something like this.
I deeply believe these are not the plugins that make your music or your sound great. It's much more about your taste, sensitivity, creativity, your imagination, all the things that construct this human being that you are, than about your plugins.
Well, let's make a double check on what I just said, and let's actually create two voiceover tracks. First one using my paid, top-notch, best plugins I'm using every day, and the second one using free plugins available to absolutely everybody. Let's clash the tracks and let's see if it's really more about skills than about plugins. And hey, let's welcome new people on my channel, Studio Mike, Joel, Autumn, and many others. I'm really glad to have you here, guys, and I hope you're happy with what I'm presenting to you, because I am really, really happy with all your feedback and your presence. So I hope my tiny community to grow, and always feel free to subscribe, get notified, and discuss the things with me down below in the comments. And now let's go. I have to tell you that I believe today's task is not going to be too difficult, because, well, we're working with Josh, who's actually a really talented and skilled man, and this is a first ingredient to succeed in recording and editing a good sounding voiceover. Work with a good voiceover talent. The second thing, work with a good audio director or learn directing voices yourself. This topic is a vast one, so we're not going to talk about it. Just take that into account and let's take a look at our session actually. Our session is 48 kHz 24-bit, which is a typical for video, film, television, multimedia work, and this is what you usually should record when thinking about voiceovers. And I got a couple of takes from Josh and I put them here on the timeline, as you can see, so I can choose them. And first thing I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna edit. So I'm gonna listen to them all and I'm gonna choose the best chunks to make them one piece of my favorite sound and expression. Let's go. Okay, I'm there, I've just finished. Take a look. As you can see, I used three colors because I actually used three takes to edit it into one take of my choice. And first, I want you to listen to it. Let's go.
Hi, Josh Skjold here for Folia Sound Studio. We hope you like this tutorial and find it inspiring, informative, and fun. If you do, please remember to hit the subscribe button, like the vid, and leave the comment down below. Feel free to contact us for both voiceover and sound post services. We are a skilled and experienced team. We work fast and we use top-notch tools to provide you with the best audio quality for any of your projects. You'll find our email addresses at the end of the video. Hope to hear from you soon.
Yeah, that's it. Josh recorded this at home using Yeti Blue Mic USB version. So as you can see, the quality is really all right. I already like it and I think it sounds good just as it is, but let's continue. And let's take a closer look at the cuts. As you can see, everything has got fade-ins, fade-outs, crossfades when needed. Also, I did some leveling here, like manual leveling, using some longer crossfades. And that's going to be the third thing I'm going to recommend to you when working with voiceovers. Do not be afraid to edit deep and avoid, when possible, using automatic functions and auto plugins. Make it handcrafted and make it custom. So avoid gating, avoid auto leveling, especially on short forms. Of course, when it's long, gating, vocal writing, it's all fair to use it. Let's continue. Let's make it just one color and let's duplicate, because this is going to be paid and this is going to be free. And we're gonna get back to it very, very soon. For now, paid plugins. The first of my paid plugins I'm gonna use is going to be iZotope RX7 Advanced. This is the tool I cannot really work without for any pops, clicks, any unneeded artifacts. I'm cleaning it all using RX. So now let's speed it up and let me do my work in RX. Yeah, I've just finished. I'm there. And yeah, just editing and cleaning the tracks up using Nuendo, using my Metagrid together with RX7 Advanced is a pure dream, sound designer's dream. I could not recommend it more. But let's go on and let's start mixing what we have here. And mixing, this is our chain. The first plugin I'm gonna use is going to be Smart EQ by Sonable. And it's here. I'm gonna use a speech algorithm and I'm gonna tell it to learn the curve from the recording.
Hi, Josh Skjold here for Folia Sound Studio. We hope you like this tutorial and find it inspiring, informative, and fun. If you do, please remember to hit the subscribe button, like the vid, and leave the comment down below. Feel free to contact.
That's it. This is a huge problem saver. And this is the first instance for me when mixing vocals, always. Because any resonances, any unneeded, unbalanced frequencies are gone. And this speech algo is great. I'm just not letting it work in the bass because it tends to cut the bass a little bit too much. So let's continue and let's use Pro Q3. It's here and we're gonna listen again and we're gonna mix more.
Hi, Josh Skjold here for Folia Sound Studio. We hope you like this tutorial and find it inspiring, informative, and fun. If you do, please remember to hit the subscribe button, like the vid, and leave the comment down below. Feel free to contact us for both voiceover and sound post services. We are a skilled and experienced team. We work fast and we use top-notch tools to provide you with the best audio quality for any of your projects. You'll find our email addresses at the end of the video.
Is it really better? Let's compare.
Hi, Josh Skjold here for Folia Sound Studio. We hope you like this tutorial and find it inspiring, informative, and fun. If you do, please remember to hit the subscribe button, like the vid, and leave the comment down below.
Yeah, it really is better. And the last instance for finding unneeded resonances and doing some additional dynamic EQing is going to be Soothe 2, which I really also love a lot. Let's listen.
If you do, please remember to hit the subscribe button, like the vid, and leave the comment down below. Feel free to contact us for both voiceover and sound post service. Hi.
There is some resonance I need to find manually still and take care of. Let's go.
If you do, please remember to hit the subscribe button, like the vid, and leave the comment down below. Feel free to contact us for both voiceover and sound post services.
That's it. I believe that this is really well-balanced, good-sounding recording. And the next step for me is Harmonix Exciting. I usually am using Vitamin by Waves for this. And let's welcome it on the timeline and let's continue.
Hi, Josh Skjold here for Folia Sound Studio. We hope you like this tutorial and find it inspiring, informative, and fun. We are a skilled and experienced team. We work fast and we use top-notch tools to provide you with the best audio quality for any of your projects.
Yeah, I like it. It's good. But there's another stage needed and it's gonna be de-essing. My favorite de-esser is just an onboard Nuendo's de-esser, which I find totally amazing and I don't need to buy anything else.
Hi, Josh Skjold here for Folia Sound Studio. Feel free to contact us for both voiceover and sound post services.
I think that one de-esser here is enough, but for example, when I work with Polish text in my language, sometimes I use two or three of them for S's and for the sh, 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 and sh, sh, sh. All of them are sometimes separated, and it's totally fine when you use more than one de-esser, remember. Let's go on. The last thing I'm gonna use, because I mean, using it sometimes, it's Gullfoss by Sound Theory, which is this last, very last EQing magic sauce that sometimes help to get this 5-10% of extra on the track. Let's listen.
Hi, Josh Skjold here for Folia Sound Studio. We hope you like this tutorial and find it inspiring, informative, and fun. If you do, please remember to hit the subscribe button, like the vid, and leave the comment down below.
I believe it's fine. Let's continue and let's compress our signal. My main compressor for vocals and for voiceovers is actually Distressor from Universal Audio. It's full of character, it's full of punch, full of color, but you know what? I'm not afraid of it. I'm fully fine with it and I love its sound, so let's work with it a little bit and let's tweak the knobs.
Hi, Josh Skjold here for Folia Sound Studio. We hope you like this tutorial and find it inspiring, informative, and fun. If you do, please remember to hit the subscribe button, like the vid, and leave the comment down below.
Yeah, what I can hear now, that actually this recording has got some very slight reverb, and now when compressed, it's audible. So let's move our inserts and let's use the reverb from RX.
Hi, Josh Skjold here for Folia Sound Studio. We hope you like this tutorial and find it inspiring, informative, and fun. If you do, please remember to hit the subscribe button, like the vid.
Yeah, you should always remember not to push it too hard, because it's gonna make your sound dim, dull, and soapy, as I call it. So really just a little bit of reverb reduction. And the next step, and the last step actually, this is limiting, and my favorite, absolutely favorite limiter and maximizer for now, it's Pro L by Fab Filter. Let's go and use it now.
Hi, Josh Skjold here for Folia Sound Studio. We hope you like this tutorial and find it inspiring, informative, and fun. If you do, please remember to hit the subscribe button, like the vid, and
Yeah, that's mainly it. I really like the sound. And what I do at the very, very end is that I listen to everything again, and I'm making the last, very last tweaks. I also sometimes listen to some references, just according to what the client would like to hear, because now it's pushed quite hard because it's for commercial use. When it's easier, longer voiceover, like for documentary or for anything else, for an audiobook, for example, anything that's long, you do not have to make the harmonic excitement in the highs so obvious. You do not have to compress it and limit it so hard. Also remember about this, that you should adapt your mix to your certain needs. Yeah, that's it. I believe I'm really, really done with the paid version. So we have listened to it. We know what's up. Let's switch to free plugins so then we can compare how it stands up against paid plugins. I can't really wait for it. Here it is. This is our free version of this voiceover track. Of course, we're not gonna use any de-reverb, we're not gonna use RX Advanced or any RX repair because it's paid, so it's not allowed here. Let's start with EQing then. You might have noticed I'm actually using GE Gentleman's edition of TDR Nova, which is a paid one, but hey, I'm only using the features that are also available in a free version, so no smart ops, no stuff like that, just the simplest Nova EQing, okay? Let's continue. And the next stage is going to be harmonic excitement. And I'm going to use Thrillseeker by Variety of Sound. It's a really good one. It's a free one. And I'm really interested how it's going to stand up against Vitamin. More or less like this. De-essing next stage. Really, it's not a bad one, and it's totally free. Now, compression, and there's a plugin of my choice. That's Klangholm's MJUC Junior. I really love this sound, and I'm gonna stick to it. Really, really not bad, not too bad, right? And the last thing, limiter. And the big moment comes. We're gonna listen both to paid and free versions so that we really know if plugins are so unimportant and it's so much about skills and actually, do I have skills? Let's go.
Hi, Josh Skjold here for Folia Sound Studio. Hi, Josh Skjold here for Folia Sound Studio. We hope you like this tutorial and find it inspiring, informative, and fun. We hope you like this tutorial and find it inspiring, informative, and fun. If you do, please remember to hit the subscribe button, like the vid, and leave the comment down below. Feel free to contact us for both voiceover and sound post services. We are a skilled and experienced team. We work fast and we use top-notch tools to provide you with the best audio quality for any of your projects. You'll find our email addresses at the end of the video. Hope to hear from you soon.
Guys, I have to tell you two things. First, free plugins are great. I did not expect this to turn out so good. The second thing, I got skills. I mean, I'm sorry to say this, but I do got skills. I mean, all this theory that it's more about skills than plugins. I'm happy that it's really, I had to put myself into a serious test. And yeah, it's true. You can hear it, I believe. Free plugins are cool and you're able to achieve results using them. And I hope it was kind of a complete tutorial of producing a good sounding voiceover. So I'm thrilled and excited to sum the things up for you. And this summary is a pure pleasure for me because I've got four conclusions for you. First, train your skills. Second, work with good voiceover talents. Three, do not be afraid to use free plugins if you cannot afford paid tools. Why? Because yeah, of course, there were some minor differences. I could hear some pops, clicks, artifacts, but very minor ones. I could hear the reverb floor a little bit up, but the general tonal quality, the tonal balance, the dynamics of the free version was really absolutely amazing. So yeah, I hope this tutorial was something usable for you. This is really how I work on voiceovers in the studio. This is my experience, everything summed up in this video. I hope you can use it in your own work. And I'm just happy to think that I'm gonna see you back again soon, guys. Take care.